Welcome to CrossGems. If you are interested in learning how to change materials, textures, and environment, or how to create a new one to have an excellent render, stay here because this is your video. Now, let's design. The first thing we will do is to download the file that I will leave in the description. Select the file and click on Download. Now we open it. You can also use your own designs if you prefer. We can edit the ring if we want it, to the side size, since it is parametric, as you can see, modifying the diameter or the gem size. Once ready, let's hide the rails, curves, and profiles. From the layers options, click to the right of the color boxes. Then select the curves and hide them. We will check the ring so that there are no faults that can spoil the render. Pressing F7, we can hide the grid. Once we have checked that everything is okay, we are going to grow up the ring by parts to be able to change the color easily and quickly. From the material panel, we can select the objects by command and color. Select the wall body part and click on the group at the edit dropdown. We are not going to group the trilogy because we are going to select different colors by the gems. Now we are going to go to the materials panel and from the dropdown we will indicate metal. Select the ring and change the material to white gold. We will change the display to ray tracing mode so that we can see the changes. Selecting the gem will automatically show the gem panel, so we will change the color to green and orange. From the ground dropdown, I will select a black ground to make it look better. I'm gonna show you two methods to change the color of the gems. Click on the wheel on the main panel and select materials. It will open the materials panel, and we can see the current materials used. If we switch to the render viewer, we will see that these materials is seen in both displays. That's because they are CrossGems materials. So the option one is to create glass material or physically pass it. We give it a name, select the gem, right click, and assign the material. Now we can change the color simply from this box, making it lighter or darker, according to the need. We accept, and in the Index of Reflection section, we can increase it to give it more attractive reflection. Of course, you can add the corresponding to your type of gem. Now I'm going to show you the second option that will be useful in case you want to visualize the gem in display render. As we can see in render mode, the assigned glass material will not look good, as it can only be seen correctly in ray traced mode. Well, then we are going to assign an environment to this material. First, we assign the custom material to this gem. We check the environment box, and we select the picture we have previously downloaded. In this way, we see that now we can see it in rendered mode. To change the color rendered mode, we'll have to modify the environment we added, changing the color. We can do it from any online page or software like Photoshop. In this case, I show it from Adobe Express. We add the file, we enlarge it, and from effects, we are going to give it a custom and modify the color and light. When we get it, just download it, and we add the picture as we did before. In this way, we will have the color in rendered mode. If we want it in redressed, we will have to increase the transparency to 100%, add a refractive index between 1.6 and 2.2, disable environment, and enable the box Fresnel reflectivity, which will make the light come bounce on the translucent material and will give it that realistic touch. Let's click on the transparency box and let's change the color. As we can see it in render mode, we can also give it a reflectivity so we can see the outline. Note that these created materials will only be saved to the file if you save it, so if you want to have them for other occasions, you will have to save them in a folder. To do this, we will right-click and select Saved File. Create a folder and save the material inside to have it for future occasions. I removed the material to show you how to load the file. Click on Add and Import from Material Library. Select the material we have saved and open it. Now we grab the material and drag it to the object we want to see. To change the color of the metal, simply duplicate an existing metal. Change the name, and in the reflectivity section, change the color to the one you need. You can change it from golden to lighter or white gold. We can also increase the reflectivity polish to have a polished and shiny effect if you need it. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, you can comment below and we will try to answer them in the part 2. If you find it useful, don't forget to subscribe. You can find us on Instagram, Facebook, and other social networks. See you in the second part.